So even a water bottle is something good to throw.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Missy, missy, missy.
Bala. Was good.
Hello, my beautiful best friend. So I'm back. Filming a Q&A. I haven't done a Q&A in a long minute. And if you're wondering what my hair is doing, I really don't know. And also I have dye on my hair from dyeing my hair. No, I have dye on my head. I asked you guys on my Twitter. I spend a lot of my life on Twitter. So if you want to follow me, it's Maljoy. Yeah, I should know my own Twitter username. I thought doing a Q&A would be a good video after the last video I posted, which was a very deep and personal video, and I thought this would give you guys an opportunity to ask me some questions. If you had any questions regarding last video or back in a sweatshirt, that's when you know it's a Q&A. I wear a sweatshirt in every Q&A, you already know. And before you ask me if I skate, I did own a skateboard when I was 5, so like... What are you currently watching on Netflix? P.S. I love you so much. I love you more. And I recently just started Gossip Girl. I know. I'm really, really late to the party. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna see if it's worth the hype. And it is. So I'm watching that right now. And if you're wondering, yes, I already watched 13 Reasons Why in like 2 days. What's your fave song at the moment? I'm gonna pull it up. It's on SoundCloud. It is called Love Scars by Lil Uzi. I love him so much. His music is so on point. Such like good hype music. Such good car music. I love it. And I know I mostly use Spotify, but SoundCloud has some songs that just Spotify isn't with yet. Oh. But if you want to follow my SoundCloud, I'm pretty sure it's just Maljoy. Oh my god, it's so good. I like that song. It's a good song. Three things I cannot live without. Bruh. I'm gonna say my YouTube. I'm gonna put my family and friends in the same category. I know that might be cheating, but like, third one, food. Yeah, my dog counts as my family, by the way. I'm gonna be honest about this. Someone asked me what's my dream car. So I always like to keep it real with you guys and be honest with you guys, because that's who I am. That's what I value in a person and everything. Just loyalty, realness. This is all I need. I have not told my YouTube this or any of my social media, really, a little bit on Snapchat, but like barely, because I didn't want to seem like I was bragging or that I was like so sick and I got my dream car and whatever, because that's just not who I am. I'm not gonna be like cocky. A lot of you guys have been asking if I got a new car, because I did a day in my life where I went BMW shopping and I ended up actually getting a different car than a BMW. I just like went for it and I got my dream car, and it makes me so unbelievably happy. I love cars. I pretty much feel like I could live in my car. That's how much I love it. But I got a Range Rover Sport 2017. All black is what I love. Oh my god. Like, don't even get me started. I will literally start crying. As much as I love my car and as much as whatever, I would not have been able to lease it. I did lease it. Without you guys, I love you. I love you. You're amazing. You're my favorite people ever. Know that. And know that I would rather have you guys in my life than that car. That's just, that's what I wanted to point out. New merch coming soon. And there is a little bit of new merch on my website right now. They changed the URL, so I should really address this. It's bit.ly/mel-joy. I don't know how we lost /meljoy. I don't know what happened. Some MMAN hoodies in gray that wasn't there, and then the Deuces cropped hoodie in gray that wasn't there. I don't know if I said that in a video or not. Probably did, to be honest. Also a mug that says Deuces, and my new favorite hoodie of my entire merch line. Oh my god, I'm obsessed with it. It's an all white zip up, and then on the back it says Deuces in red, like graphic. It's like the Pablo font, pretty much. I hope you guys like it too. It will be linked down below if you want to check it out. And also, I don't know if I'm allowed to say this yet, but I think I am. I'm coming out with a new necklace soon, so stay tuned for that. It's like a choker and it's something I love on it. You'll just have to wait and see, because I'm obsessed with it and I hope you guys like it too. It's more my style. My last necklace, I like it, the Lotus one. It's a little less my style now, and this one is like something I'll wear every day, so I'm really happy about it. What's your workout routine? Okay, this is a really good question, because I was really, really, really into working out. I talked about that in my last video. Lost a lot of weight, whatever. So now I'm all about balance. Like, I eat healthy, but then I have cheat days, or I just like am in the mood for burrito. I'm gonna get a burrito. Usually I do like little workouts at home, just because going to the gym just really like makes me lazy and I just lay on my phone. What I love doing is just putting on headphones, blasting music, like dancing around in my room, as stupid as it seems, but I literally like get a sweat from that, and I like my heart rate gets really up, so like I kind of count that as cardio. And then we have a bike in my house, like a stationary bike. That's what we have. We have a stationary bike, so I will occasionally ride that. Last time I think I did like 13 miles. I can like spend forever on that thing, because I just sit on my phone and like bike. So it's like really nice. And then I usually do like abs, butt, legs, whatever. I mix it up, but I usually do that. But for me, I've just realized that everything is balanced. Everything is balanced. So fave Starbucks order. I have not told you guys this, and this is so weird for me to even say, but I used to drink coffee every single morning, at least one cup, like 12 ounces. And then I realized, I was like, do I want to rely on coffee as much as I do? Because I was relying on coffee so heavily much. I'd be like, I can't get out of bed unless I have my coffee. Like, it was bad. I took coffee out of my diet. Well, not took it out, but I don't drink it every morning. Instead, I drink green tea. I'm pointing to it over there because I see it. It's Lipton green tea. I put some stevia. You guys always correct me on that. And it's really good. And I try drinking that instead because green tea is actually really good for your skin. And my skin was really bad a couple months ago. And now it's gotten better because I've just tried to take care of myself. But if I do go to Starbucks and if I do get coffee, it'll probably be a venti. Because go big or go home. I get just an iced coffee with soy milk. And then I get like the little Good Earth packages or whatever they are, like the green ones. And I put like two or three of those in for some sweetness, but without having real sugar, because sugar is bad for you. So that's my Starbucks order. Someone asked me, I really like this question. Who would you say is the most influential person in your life? And it's definitely 100% my dad. He's literally my best friend. I tell him everything. We're like the same person. Like we have the same morals, just everything. I just relate to him so crazy much. And I feel like he's just like literally my best friend, which is so dope to have a parent as a best friend because they're always there for you no matter what. And I don't know, Dad, if you're watching this, I love you. I would not be who I am today without you, like, honestly, 100%. He's always like, maybe you were just born like that. I'm like, nah, bro, you grew me up. Like, how do you stay positive? I struggle with this so much. P.S. I love you. I love you more. I did address in my last video that, like, I was super underweight, and then I gained back weight now, and I'm a lot happier with it and in general and whatever. But the way to stay body positive, that's a really hard question just because there's so many girls on Instagram that are looking like amazing bodies, perfect bodies, whatever. But you also gotta realize there's a lot of editing in that. There's a lot of editing that could go on that you wouldn't even be sure about. Like, I just want you to know, never compare yourselves to people you see on your feed or whatever, because I don't know, the whole situation's kinda like effed up. But I don't even know where I was going with that. Wow, I'm such a ranter. No matter what you look like, whatever, you need to be happy with it. If you think you're overweight, if you think you're underweight and you want to change it, make a move to change it. Just do it in a healthy way to look in the mirror and be like, I am beautiful the way I am, and I need to know that. It's just all like a mindset. Like, you need to just love your body. Give it attention, love it, and it'll love you back. I don't even know if that made sense, but I hope it did. So staying on the topic of like weight and body, someone asked me, how did you gain your healthy weight? Well, I was on like this diet where I pretty much ate the same thing every day because when I like something, I don't get sick of it. Like, I could eat the same breakfast, the same lunch, the same dinner every day and be like, yeah, I like it, I'm gonna stick with it. Hard for me to branch out sometimes, gonna be honest. But I had like a very strict, not strict, but like since I liked it, I would eat it every day or most days. I don't know if it just wasn't enough or I was also working out too much because I would go to the gym literally every day for like hours and it was just a lot, I guess. So I think everything in moderation, something that I do now. If you want to gain more healthy weight, it's not just like, oh, I'm going to eat a bunch of like crap and put it in my body because that's not good for your body. I don't really know. I just kind of started eating what I felt like and what my body told me I wanted. And I think that helped a lot because I was like, if I'm craving a burrito, I'll have a burrito. If I want like falafel, which I would really crave a lot, I'd be like, I'm going to have a falafel. So it's really just listen to your body. Just don't be crazy with like the unhealthy eating, but it's not bad to have cheat days and to eat what you feel like you want. Yeah, no. Tips on dealing with fake friends. I love you. I love you too. I probably feel like I address fake friends in like every Q&A, but it's something that I cannot stand. Like, even thinking about it just makes me want to like, bruh. I just don't understand the whole idea of fakeness. Will never make sense to me. My advice for you is to see if they're really there for you when you're at your worst. And if you're not feeling good, if they're gonna comfort you and they're gonna ask if you're okay and they're gonna check up on you and everything. And just if they seem like they care, if they genuinely seem like they care, then you got a good one. Or they just talk to you when they need or like want something from you, that's when you know. I've had some instances with people that don't hit me up unless they're asking for something, which is like, bruh. But whatever, it's cool, you do you, but like, I just don't want someone like that in my life, you feel me? You can't change someone. It's just not like, I don't know, polite to be like, I'm gonna change you to someone who I want you to be. And it's just like, nah. My advice to you is to just remove them from your life. If you know that they're, if you're aware that they're a fake friend, just what's the point? What's the point of putting yourself through that? That's what I've realized. What's your favorite song from Blackbear's new album? digital drug lord. Lol, mine's Doremi. I love you so much. I love you more. My favorite song from his new album is probably Chateau. When I play that in the car, I go hard. Watch out for them slink ones. Motto! So someone asked, are you gonna do another car tour video? This goes along with the other car question. But if you guys would like to see that, I would love to do it just because it's my baby. I will do it if you want me to. But I totally understand if you guys don't want to see that because, I don't know, it's just not the most modest thing ever. And I try to stay modest and humble. I just don't want to be putting that in someone's face. Look at my new car! So like, if you don't want to see it, totally understand. But let me know down below if you'd like to because I want to do what you guys want to see. You feel me? So someone asks, are you coming to VidCon? Girl, I'm gonna be there. Me and Olivia right now are planning. She better come with me. I'll be pissed if she doesn't. But we're planning right now to road trip down there together like we did last year, which was so fun, and go to VidCon because VidCon is dope and I love meeting you guys. So caffeinate VidCon 2017. My friend just said, all your posts just popped up in my feed. I said, blessed your feed. So I think that's all for this video. It was a very chill video, but don't worry, next week's video is gonna be dope, hopefully. But let me know down below what you guys want to see, because I am having a little bit of like YouTube writer's block. If you want to see any like makeup tutorials, everyday makeup, a haul is coming soon, stay tuned. I didn't have time to do it today because I have to leave soon. I love you guys to infinity and beyond. I mean it when I say it, and I hope you know that. And it feels so good to be back and be filming. I missed you guys, and I don't know, you're my faves, know that. I hope you're having a marvelous morning, afternoon, or night, and I will hopefully see you in my next video. Deuces! Ooh, deuces! Ooh. Deuces!